morning children. Today we are going to see the remaining topics of the geography lesson: land, soil, water, natural vegetation and wildlife resources. Okay children, first we will see about water. See children, we know very well water is one of the most important natural resources. Yes, it is essential for our life, isn't it? See, water on earth exists mainly in three forms. What are they? Water vapor in the atmosphere, water in the oceans, rivers and lakes, and ice in the mountains and polar regions. So before going to see that, water is one of those resources without which plants and animals cannot exist, isn't it? See children, 3/4 of the earth's surface is covered with water. Okay, so almost 75% of the surface of the earth is covered with water. So the earth is called the water planet, right? And also it is known as blue planet, isn't it? Because 75% of the surface of the earth is covered with water, isn't it? And in that, ocean water is saline, right? Always it is salty, so that it won't fit for domestic use or irrigation for industries and all. So fresh water is just about 2.7% of the total water. In fact, fresh water's percentage is only 2.7%, but we will get only 1% of the fresh water for human use. So always fresh water is very scarce. Okay, see children, actually 2/3 of the earth's surface, the sea water being saline, is in unfit for human consumption, but most of the fresh water too is in the form of frozen glaciers and ice caps in the Arctic region, Antarctica, Greenland and snow covered mountains. So in the 2.5% of the earth's fresh water, almost most of the fresh water is in the form of frozen glaciers, ice caps in the Arctic region, Antarctica, Greenland and snow covered mountains. The remaining unfrozen fresh water is mainly found where? It is found as groundwater, as surface water in rivers and lakes, and as water vapor in the atmosphere. So in what forms is fresh water found on the earth? Fresh water is found in the forms of groundwater, water in rivers and lakes, and as water vapor. So only 1% of the fresh water we will get, that also in the fresh water found on the in the forms of groundwater, water in rivers and lakes, and as water vapor, isn't it? Yes, because oceans water will be saline, right? So that it won't be used, it's unfit for human consumption, right? So that remaining unfrozen fresh water is mainly found as groundwater, right? In the form of rivers and lakes, and also as water vapor. Got it? See children, in countries like Saudi Arabia and Middle Eastern countries where there is acute shortage of water, always there will be water problem. So what they will do, desalination plants are used to make seawater fit for drinking. அதாவது கடல் நீரை சுத்திகரிக்கும் பிளான்ட் இருக்குல்ல, அதுதான் டீசலினேஷன் பிளான்ட்ஸ். சி ரிஃபைனரி வாட்டர்னு சொல்லுவாங்க. ஸோ தட் டீசலினேஷன் பிளான்ட்ஸ் ஆர் யூஸ்டு டு மேக் சீ வாட்டர் ஃபிட் ஃபார் ட்ரிங்கிங். ஓகே, அண்ட் வி நோ வெரி வெல் ஒன்லி 1% ஆஃப் த ஃப்ரெஷ் வாட்டர் இஸ் அவைலபிள் ஃபார் டொமஸ்டிக் அண்ட் இண்டஸ்ட்ரியல் யூஸ், are like irrigation, power generation and so on. See, domestic means what? domestic means we need water for drinking, cleaning, cooking, washing, and for growing food, right? And not only that, we also need water for irrigation, transportation, manufacturing industry, and process plants, as well as generation of electricity. Now hydroelectricity is produced, right, from reservoirs of dams, isn't it? So that not only for drinking, but also water is used for every activities. So water is very, very important resource, isn't it? Yes. So children, fresh water is the most precious substance on earth. So which is the most precious substance on earth? Fresh water. Got it? So which is the most precious substance on earth? Fresh water. You know children, fresh water can neither be added nor subtracted from the earth. It's constant. We can't change it. So water can neither be added, neither can be added, extra add pannavum mudiyadhu and not subtracted, adhula irundhu korekkavum mudiyadhu. Its total volume remains constant. Okay, so which is the most precious substance on earth? Fresh water. Got it? Will you forget it? You should not forget it. Okay, because water is very, very important for our life. Okay, children, now we will see what are the factors lead to water scarcity, especially present days. Because human huge amounts of water, not only for drinking, already I have told you, but also the process of production, right, for agriculture, industries, then generating electricity through reservoirs of dams, isn't it? Now then other factors, increasing population. Nowadays population is growing on, right? For that, rising demands for food and cash crops. So both are in hand in hand. If population increases, what will happen? Needs of food crops will be high. So and also one more thing, increasing urbanization and rising standards of living are the major factors. Because urbanization means nagarmaya model solvanga, like romba crowd a metropolitan cities engime, for example Chennai, Mumbai, Delhi, Calcutta, eduthona enna romba crowd, it will be more crowd. So urbanization, it is called. So increasing population, rising demands for food and cash crops, then increasing urbanization and rising standards of living. Nowadays compared than earlier, nowadays our standard of living is high. So these are the major factors to lead the water scarcity, or we are facing water shortage, right? For shortages in supply of fresh water, right? So we will see about problems of water availability. Okay, see, in many regions in the world, most of Africa, West Asia, South Asia, parts of Western USA, Northwest Mexico, parts of South America, and entire Australia are facing shortages in fresh water supply. You know children, countries located in climatic zones most susceptible to drought face great problems of water scarcity. Precipitation means rain, right? This is also one of the factor. So in worldwide, so many countries are facing water scarcity. Got it? Especially countries located in climatic zone are facing drought nena varachi romba adhigama face pandranga. Okay, see children, at present, in fact today's world, water pollution has become a major challenge. Do you agree? Yes. Pollutants like industrial wastage, discharge in the rivers, even chemical fertilizers in agriculture, then toxic chemicals like pesticide,
and untreated or partially treated sewage then contaminate the rivers and streams and make the water unfit for human consumption. Yes. See, for example, I tell you that dyeing factory water, then for example, I tell you that chayapattara kalivu, dyeing factory water, if it mixes with river water, for example, Kaveri River, generally we can hear in our locality, don't drink Kaveri water without boiling because the chayapattara kalivu ella adile mix a irukku, water contaminate a irukku nu solli. So in this way also water gets polluted. Okay, like this overuse of pesticides and fertilizers, if it mixes with the river water, that also affect water, right? And another thing, partially treated or untreated sewage and all, if it mixes with the water, that also will affect water. It pollutes water. So in this way water gets polluted. So in this world, which is the most precious substance? Of course, fresh water, because only 1% only we are getting fresh water. So we should use it in proper way. So we have to conserve and preserve it. So what are the steps have taken to conserve water resources? Let us see in one by one. Okay. Some methods of water conservation are water harvesting, sprinklers, drip irrigation, and stop leakages, then avoid water pollution. See children, water harvesting method can also be used to save surface runoff. Do you know the meaning of surface runoff? Water flow on surface. அதாவது தண்ணி அடிச்சிட்டு கிரவுண்டில் தண்ணி அடிச்சிட்டு போகிறது, வேஸ்ட்டாக அடிச்சிட்டு போகிறதெல்லாம் அவாய்ட் பண்ணுறது. ஸோ ஈவன் மழை வந்ததுன்னா எவ்வளோ மழை தண்ணி வீணாக அடிச்சிட்டு போகுது, அதெல்லாம் இல்லாமல் ஹார்வெஸ்ட் பண்ணும். ஸோ தட்ஸ் வை ரெயின் வாட்டர் ஹார்வெஸ்டிங் இஸ் இன்சிஸ்டட், ரைட்? ஸோ தட் ஹார்வெஸ்டிங் மெத்தட், ஸோ விச் மெத்தட் இஸ் யூஸ்டு டு சேவ் சர்ஃபேஸ் ரன் ஆஃப்? வாட்டர் ஹார்வெஸ்டிங் மெத்தட். Okay, so water harvesting method can also be used to save surface runoff. Then water is used for irrigating fields. The canals should be properly lined to minimize losses by water seepage. So நம்ம அந்த வாட்டர் ஃபீல்டில் வயலில் தண்ணி பாய்ச்சிறப்போ என்ன ஆகணும், அது ப்ராப்பராக வித்தவுட் லூசிங், வித்தவுட் வித்தவுட் வேஸ்டேஜ் ஆஃப் வாட்டர் it should be done. In this way also we can save water. Children, now we will see about rainwater harvesting. Actually, rainwater harvesting system is very simple and can be built in every house, school, institution, playground, etc. Because it's very 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 useful to collect water, right? See children, rainwater harvesting is the process of collecting rainwater from the rooftop in a specific place where it is stored for future use. Okay. See children, instead of irrigating the crops by flooding the field with water, watering the crops with drip irrigation or sprinklers can save plenty of water. These are the advisable methods to use in the fields. So sprinklers and drip irrigation methods are advisable. Okay, then stop leakages of water at every stage by following good plumbing techniques and using high quality pipes and appliances. Yes, that is very important. Yes, nowadays we can see in roadside, if you see the PVC pipes and all get damaged and water is wasted. Many places we can see this problem. So appropriate appliances should be used, then only water will be saved. Okay, and also we should not use drinking water as a washing for cars and washing clothes
for any other extra household works and all. We should use only for drinking. Okay. So, each one of us must contribute to conserve water. Okay. Children, now let's move on to natural vegetation and wildlife. First, we will see about natural vegetation.
See children, natural vegetation and wildlife are valuable natural resources. Actually, natural vegetation and wildlife exist only in the narrow zone called biosphere, where the lithosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere meet and interact, isn't it? So, natural vegetation and wildlife exist only in the biosphere. Yes, the narrow zone of contact between the lithosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere is called biosphere. Yes, so what do you mean by biosphere? The narrow zone of contact between the lithosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere is called biosphere. So, natural vegetation and wildlife exist only in the biosphere, isn't it? Yes. See children, all living beings in the biosphere, whether they belong to plant life or animal kingdom, are interrelated and interdependent on each other for survival. This interaction of organisms in a particular area with their physical environment is known as an ecosystem. So, simply we can say, what is ecosystem? In the biosphere, living beings are interrelated and interdependent on each other for survival. This life supporting system is known as the ecosystem. Okay, so once again let me tell you about biosphere. So what is biosphere? Natural vegetation and wildlife exist only in the narrow zone of contact between lithosphere, hydrosphere and atmosphere, that is called biosphere. Is that clear? Children, what do you know about natural vegetation? Actually, natural vegetation refers to the group of plants which grow in an area without the interference of human beings. So, without the interference of human beings, a group of plants which grow in an area is called natural vegetation. Okay, so what do you mean by natural vegetation? Natural vegetation refers to the group of plants which grow in an area without the interference of human beings. Got it? So, this is called natural vegetation. See children, generally, plants provide us obviously oxygen, very first, right? Then food, timber, firewood, then medicinal substances, medicinal value, herbs, right? Then other useful things that satisfy various human needs, isn't it? Yes. And also they bind the, means plants bind the soil and check soil erosion. Yes, already I have told you, plants' roots hold soil firmly, right? So that natural vegetation prevents soil erosion, in fact landslides, then land degradation. Okay. See children, wildlife includes animals, birds, insects as well as the aquatic life forms. Already you know about all those things, right? Aquatic form means thanniyila irukkira ella animals, right? So aquatic animals. Then they provide us, generally animals provide us milk, meat, hides. Hides means what? Skin of the animals, and wool. And also insects like bees provide us honey, right? And help in pollination of flowers and have an important role to play as decomposers in the ecosystem. Then the birds feed on insects and act as decomposers as well. Do you know children, Vulture, due to its ability to feed on dead livestock, is a scavenger and considered a vital cleanser of the environment. So, which one is considered as a cleanser of the environment? Vulture. Got it? So, animals big or small, all are integral to maintaining balance in the ecosystem. Okay. Now, we will see about distribution of natural vegetation. See children, basically the growth of vegetation depends primarily on temperature and moisture. Yes, in fact we can see particular area, certain area some plants will grow. But on the contrary, in the other regions the plants won't grow because of the place's temperature and moisture won't be suitable. Okay. Then the major vegetation types of the world are grouped as forests, grasslands, scrubs and tundra. Children, scrubs means desert vegetation. See children, now we will see how trees will grow in different regions. See, in areas of heavy rainfall, huge trees may grow. Yes, of course, because it gets more water, right? So, the forests are associated with areas having abundant water supply. So that, what is that? Huge trees will grow. Then, as the amount of moisture decreases, the size of trees and their density reduces. So, where there is no moisture, means less moisture, according to the size of trees and the density reduces. Okay. Then, in the regions of moderate rainfall, short stunted trees and grasses grow, forming the grasslands of the world. So, where grasslands generally formed? In the regions of moderate rainfall, isn't it? So, don't forget it. Where there is heavy rain, huge trees will grow. Where there is moderate amount of rainfall, there is grassland will be there. Okay. And at the same time, in dry areas of low rainfall, thorny shrubs and scrubs grow. For example, cactus, right? And in such areas, plants have deep roots and the leaves have thorny and waxy surface to reduce loss of moisture by transpiration. Then at last, tundra vegetation. Tundra vegetation of cold polar regions comprise of mosses and lichens. Okay. Children, let me tell you about tundra region, tundra vegetation. See, while hot deserts can support thorn bushes and shrubs like cactus, like thorn bushes and shrubs, whereas cold deserts support only plants like mosses and lichens. Okay, so tundra vegetation, where it will be? It's in the polar region, right? But thorn bushes and shrubs will be in deserts area, hot deserts area. Okay. Types of forests. Forests are classified into evergreen forests and deciduous forests. See children, generally forests are broadly classified as our evergreen and deciduous on the basis of when they shed their leaves. So, forests are broadly classified how? On the basis of when they shed their leaves. So, forests are broadly classified as evergreen forest and deciduous forest. Okay. Now, I will tell you about evergreen forest. See children, evergreen name itself tells us always throughout the year it will be green only. Right. But on the contrary, the deciduous forest, it won't be like that. I'll show you the picture of deciduous forest. This is a picture of deciduous forest. See
See children, deciduous forests shed their leaves in a particular season to conserve loss of moisture through transpiration. So, deciduous forests shed their leaves in a particular season to conserve loss of moisture through transpiration. Children, difference between evergreen forest and deciduous forest. See children, let me tell you the main difference between the evergreen forest and deciduous forest. See, trees of evergreen forest do not shed their leaves simultaneously in any season of the year. But deciduous forest shed their leaves in a particular season to conserve loss of moisture through transpiration. This is the major difference between evergreen forest and deciduous forest. Okay, these forests are further classified as tropical or temperate based on their location in different latitudes. So children, these forests, whether evergreen or deciduous forest, further classified as tropical or temperate. We are known tropical zone and temperate zone, right? So these forests are further classified as tropical or temperate based on their location in different latitudes. Got it? Now we will see about conservation of natural vegetation and wildlife. Before entering into this, once again I will repeat about wildlife. See children, wildlife includes animals, birds, insects as well as the aquatic life forms. Already I have told you, right? And also they provide us milk, meat, hides and wool, isn't it? Yes. Then insects like bees provide us honey and help in pollination of flowers and have an important role to play as decomposers in the ecosystem, isn't it? Actually, the birds feed on insects and act as decomposers as well, right? Then vulture, due to its ability to feed on dead livestock, is a scavenger and considered a vital cleanser of the environment. Already I have told you about vulture is considered as a cleanser of the environment, and it is also a scavenger, right? So don't forget that. Now we will see about conservation of natural vegetation and wildlife. See children, forests are our wealth, right? Forests provide natural shelters to the plants and animals, right? Even several species of plants and animals are in the forest, right? So changes in climate and human interferences can cause the loss of natural inhabitants for the plants and animals. So at last what happened? Human interferences is the biggest problem, right? Then commercial exploitation of forests due to human greed is the main cause for deforestation. Yes? So many species have become vulnerable or endangered, and some are on the verge of extinction. It means endangered means risk of being destroyed. அதாவது அழிஞ்சு போற நிலைமையில இருக்கு, அழியிற தருவாயில இருக்குன்னு சொல்லுவோம்ல தமிழ்ல, அதுதான் endangered species. Okay, so deforestation, soil erosion, constructional activities, forest fires, tsunami and landslides are some of the human-made and natural factors which affect this wildlife and natural vegetation resources. Okay, see, next we will see about the conservation of natural vegetation. See children, let me tell you some facts regarding forest fire. See, recently 2009 October, Amazon rainforest was on a fire. Actually, where it is? Amazon rainforest is in Brazil, right? Okay, see, Amazon rainforest is the lungs of the world, right? So that after it got fire, globally it was given more importance to of it, because it affects animals and plants, even it increases the global warming. So that worldwide countries gave importance to put off the fire. Okay, let me tell you what are the steps have to take to conserve the forest. Okay, first step, massive afforestation work should be undertaken to expand the forest. Yes, afforestation means growing trees, growing more trees and plants, right? So massive afforestation work should be undertaken to expand the forest. So it will not only increase the forest cover but also help in making up the eco balance. Got it? Then large scale cutting of trees should be banned. Then forest fires generally caused by smoking or careless cooking should be prevented, as forest fires are difficult to control, so that it should be prevented. Got it? Then overgrassing by cattle should be banned. So overgrassing by cattle should be banned. Specific areas should be marked for grazing of cattle. Okay, and also control forest diseases like parasitic fungi, viruses, etc. to avoid destruction of trees. So control forest diseases, and also spread awareness among all for the need to save forests. For that, Van Mahotsava should be encouraged at the regional level and community level. So awareness programs like social forestry and Vana Mahotsava should be encouraged at the regional and community level. So school children should be encouraged for growing plants and trees. Okay, so what is the Vana Mahotsava? The social program of planting trees organized at community level is called Vana Mahotsava. Okay, see children, Vanam means forest, kaad, so that you can remember this word Vana Mahotsava, to increase forest. Okay, so the social program of planting trees organized at community level is called Vana Mahotsava. Now we will see about conservation of wildlife. See children, wildlife conservation means protection of species and habitats of wild animals, right? Actually, the main objective of conservation is to ensure that their habitats will be preserved. Anga live pandra ella animalsum na adunodi adu vandu paadhukapadada abingiradhu ensure panikkanum. So the main objective of conservation is to ensure that their habitats will be preserved, so that the future generations of both wildlife and humans can enjoy it. Okay, so that wildlife conservation aims to raise awareness among people about the importance of wildlife. So by conserving and protecting the natural habitats of wildlife species, we will enrich our planet. See children, generally the animals are poached for collection and illegal trade of hides, skins, nails, teeth, horns, as well as feathers. We know very well, right? See, poached means hunting. Okay, so some of these animals are tiger, lion, elephant, deer, black buck, crocodile, rhinoceros, snow leopard, ostrich, and peacock. These can be conserved by increasing awareness. So national parks, wildlife sanctuaries, biosphere reserves are made to protect our natural vegetation and wildlife. Then conservation of creeks, lakes and wetland is necessary to save the precious resource from depletion. Already I have told you about depletion. Anudaya quantity koreyirudhu. So conservation of creeks means a tributary of river or small river. So conservation of creeks, lakes and wetland is necessary to save the precious resource from depletion. அதனோட அழிவுல இருந்து இதை காப்பாற்றணும். ஓகே, சேவ் பண்ணணும். தெர் இஸ் அ பேலன்ஸ் இன் த என்வாயன்மெண்ட் இஃப் த ரிலேட்டிவ் நம்பர் ஆஃப் ஸ்பீசிஸ் இஸ் நாட் டிஸ்டர்ப்டு. ஆக்சுவலி ஹியூமன் ஆக்டிவிட்டீஸ் இன் செவரல் பார்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் த வேர்ல்ட் ஹாவ் டிஸ்டர்ப்ட் த நேச்சுரல் ஹேபிட்ஸ் ஆஃப் மெனி ஸ்பீசிஸ். Due to indiscriminate killings, several birds and animals have either become extinct or on the verge of extinction. சிலதெல்லாம் அழிஞ்சே போயிடுச்சு, சிலெல்லாம் அழிகிற ஸ்டேஜில் இருக்குது. ஸோ அட் த ரீஜனல் லெவல் ஸ்கூல் சில்ட்ரன் ஷுட் பி என்கரேஜ்டு ஃபார் பேர்ட் வாட்சிங் அண்ட் விசிட்டிங் நேச்சர் கேம்ப்ஸ் so that they appreciate the habitat of varied species. Actually, in many countries have passed laws declaring that the trade as well as killing of birds and animals are illegal. In fact, in India, killing of lions, tigers, deer, great Indian bustards and peacocks have been banned. Yes. See children, I'll give you an example for national parks. See Kaziranga National Park, it is in Assam. So that is the example for national parks, wildlife sanctuaries. Okay. So Kaziranga National Park is located in Assam. Which state it is located? In Assam. Okay. So Kaziranga National Park is in Assam. See children, next I will explain you about sites, CITES. The expansion of sites is the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Fauna and Flora is an international agreement between governments. Actually, it aims to ensure that international trade in specimens of wild animals and plants does not threaten their survival. Roughly 5,000 species of animals and 28,000 species of plants are protected. Bears, dolphins, cacti, corals, orchids and aloes are some examples. So the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Flora and Fauna is an international agreement between governments, okay, to ensure the safety of animals. Okay, so according to CITES list, several species of animals and birds in which trade is prohibited. ப்ரொஹிபிட்டட்னா தடை பண்ணுறது. கன்சர்வேஷன் ஆஃப் பிளான்ஸ் அண்ட் அனிமல்ஸ் இன் அண்ட் எத்திக்கல் டியூட்டி ஆஃப் எவ்ரி சிட்டிசன். காட் இட் சில்ட்ரன்? ஓகே சில்ட்ரன், நவ் லெட்ஸ் ரீகால் வாட் வி ஹவ் ஸ்டடிட் ஸோ ஃபார். ஓகே சில்ட்ரன், வி சா அபவுட் லேண்ட், சாயில், வாட்டர், நேச்சுரல் வெஜிடேஷன் அண்ட் வைல்ட் லைஃப் ரிசோர்சஸ். இஸ் இன் டேட்? எஸ். Actually, let me ask you a few questions based on this topic. Okay. See, children, how many centimeters of soil forms in hundreds of years? 1 centimeter, right? Okay. Actually, how many liters of water is wasted by dripping tap in a year? 1,200 liters, isn't it? Yes. Okay. Dash should be encouraged at the regional and community level. What should be encouraged at the regional and community level? Vana Mahotsava, right? For
for growing trees, for planting more trees. It should be encouraged at the regional and community level, right? Okay. The right mix of dash and dash make soil fertile. What will come? The right mix of minerals and organic matter make the soil fertile, isn't it? Yes. Okay, children. Which is the most precious substance on earth? Fresh water, right? Okay. And the forest trees shed their leaves in a particular season is called? What else? Deciduous. Yes, because the forest trees shed their leaves in a particular season in deciduous forest. Isn't it? Yes, evergreen forest trees won't shed their leaves at all. Yes. See, children. Which is an international agreement between governments? CITES. CITES. Yes. See, children. What are made to protect our natural vegetation and wildlife? National parks, wildlife sanctuaries, and biosphere reserves. Isn't it? So, these are made to protect our natural vegetation and wildlife. Isn't it? Yes. See, the thin layer of grainy substance covering the surface of the earth is called soil. Yes? So, the thin layer of grainy substance covering the surface of the earth is called soil. Isn't it? Yes. Okay, children, we have to come to an end of this chapter. I hope you all understood this chapter clearly. I will send the classwork in the form of PDF. So you should copy it in your classwork properly and read the lesson thoroughly. Okay. Thank you, children.